nothing is impossible to God.
That means nothing is impossible.
And everything is possible for Him.
And everything is possible for Him.
According to His Word.
According to His Word.
Shall we say it again? In this hour.
In this hour.
In this place.
In this place.
I choose to believe.
I choose to believe.
That nothing is impossible to God.
That nothing is impossible to God.
And everything is possible for Him.
And everything is possible for Him.
According to His Word.
According to His Word.
So the choice is yours and mine. We can choose to believe in our fears.
Enisa ada tora ganima api satui apita biya tora gannata puluwan.
We can choose to believe in our background.
Ape pasubima gana apita viswasa karannata
puluwan. We can choose to believe in what other people are doing.
Anithay karana de pilibanda apita adahannata puluwan.
Or we can choose to believe in His Word.
Ehema nattang deviyan wahansege wacane gena apata adahannata puluwan.
And if you choose to believe in His Word,
enisa api ada thora ganimak kala thun wahansege wacane adahannata,
a whole world of possibilities open up.
Loku parasayak lokayak apata vivrutha wenawa siyalla kala heki parasayak.
Shall we welcome Jesus by giving Him a mighty hand this morning? And we say thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worship you, Father. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to your name. Worship you, Father. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glorify your name, worship you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Bless you, Lord. Honor you, Lord.
I've been set free, my God. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flock, His mercy reigns on the earth. Amazing grace.
So, this week too, we are following the method of listening to His voice through the verse that jumps into our hearts. Like I said yesterday, this week, what we are going to do?
මේ සතියේත් අපි අනුගමනය කරන්නට යනවා දේව වචනේ තුලින් අපේ හදවතට බලපාන වචනවල වලින් දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ අහඬට ඇහුම්කන් දෙන්නට.
We are going to allow the first reading to be like a light and a torch.
එනිසා පළවෙනි කියවීම තුලින් අපිට ආලෝකයක් වෙන්නට යනවා.
And it's going to give us the direction in which we should look at the gospel.
ඒ තුලින් සුවිශේෂයේ එන වචනය කෙරෙට ආලෝකයක් මඟ පෙන්වීමක් ලැබෙන්නට යනවා.
So we need to learn that.
ඒ අපි ඉගෙන ගත යුතුයි.
So let me first talk to you this morning about a concept. Each and every human being we live in a prison.
අපි හැම මිනිසෙක්ම හිරගයක් තුලයි ජීවත් වෙන්නේ.
It's we can call it the prison of our mind.
ඒක අපිට හඳුන්වන්නට පුළුවන් මනසේ හිරවීමක් කියලා.
We can call it the prison of our emotions.
අපි හැඟීම් තුල හිරවීමක් කියලා කියන්නට පුළුවන්.
හිරගයක්. So because why do we call our mind and heart a prison?
ඇයි අපි අපේ මනසත් හදවතත් හිරගයක් කියලා කියන්නේ?
Because we think that what we think and understand and feel is real.
මන්ද අපි හිතනවා අපිට දැනෙන දේ හැඟින දේ තමයි ඇත්ත කියලා.
And we stubbornly hold on to that.
ඒ නිසා අපි තදින්ම අල්ලා ගන්නවා.
So for example until the 16th century
16 වන සතවර්ෂයේ වන
most people believe that the world was flat.
ගොඩක් මිනිස්සු විශ්වාස කළා ලෝකය පැතලී කියලා.
Because they couldn't imagine a round world.
මන්ද වටකුරුව ලෝකයක් තියෙනවා කියලා උන්ට තේරුම් ගන්නට බැරි වුණා.
They asked how can people live in a round world? What will happen to the people at the bottom?
ප්‍රශ්නයක් ඇහුවා වටකුරු ලෝකයක ජීවත් වුණොත් පහළ ඉන්න මිනිස්සුන්ට මොකද වෙන්නේ කියලා.
Because they didn't know about gravity.
මන්ද ගුරුත්වාකර්ෂණය ගැන උන්ට අවබෝධයක් තිබුණේ නැහැ.
So many believe that when you go to the edge of the world you will fall off.
එනිසා බොහෝ අය හිතුවා ලෝකයේ අන්තයටම ආපුවාම මිනිස්සු වැටෙයි කියලා එතනින්.
So that was the furthest point from on the horn of Africa right at the bottom.
අප්‍රිකාවේ පල්ලෙහාම තිබුණා අන්තිම ප්‍රදේශයක්.
It's called Cape Bojado.
ඒක Cape Bojado කියලා හඳුන්වනවා.
It's not Machado's relations but Bojado. So many believe that if you go beyond Cape Bojado you'll fall off the earth.
ඉතින් ගොඩක් අය විශ්වාස කළා මේ Cape Bojado තැනට ආපුවාම ලෝකෙන් එළියට වැටෙයි කියලා.
So nobody crossed Cape Bojado for hundreds and hundreds of years.
එනිසා වර්ෂ සත සියයක් ගානක් ඔස්සේ මිනිස්සු එතනට ගියේ නැහැ වැටෙයි කියන බයට.
Because they didn't want to fall off the earth.
උන්ට ලෝකයෙන් එළියට වැටෙන්න අකමැති වෙන නිසා.
Every one of us thinking is like that.
අපි හැමෝගෙම සිතවිලිත් ඒ වගේ. අපි හිතන්නේ එහෙමයි.
I had an aunt who believed that there was a ghost behind every door.
එක නැදයක් හිටියා හැම දොරක් පිටිපස්සෙම අවතාරයක් තියෙනවා කියලා විශ්වාස කළා.
So her whole life was taking holy water and spraying every place that she went.
Enisa hamathanamtama aya giya sudha wathura aran gihilla aashirwada kala.
And she sprayed holy water under the bedpost.
And they atatat
before she went to sleep.
And they nidiyana kali and they atatat sudha wathura damma.
Because that was the world in which she lived.
Manda aya jeevathune e lokiye tulai.
There are others who live in the world of suspicion.
ඒ වගේම සමහර අය ජීවත් වෙනවා සැකය කියන ලෝකයේ තුල.
And their married life is hell.
ඒ නිසා ඔවුන්ගේ විවාහ ජීවිතය අපායක් වෙලා.
Because they suspect at every corner at everything.
මන්ද හැම අවස්ථාවකදීම ඔවුන් සැක කරනවා.
There are others who live inside fears.
ඒ වගේම සමහර අය බයවල් තුල ජීවත් වෙනවා.
Unreasonable fears.
හේතු රහිතව බයවල්.
We live inside a prison.
Enisa hiragayak tul api jeevit wenawa.
How do you come out?
Kohomada api meken eliyata enne?
That is what today's readings are about.
Ada e pilibanda thamai de wacchanein apita kiyala denne.
It is by shifting our reality.
Appe yatharthya api harawa gannata awashyai.
From our understanding to God's word.
අපිට තේරෙන දෙයින් දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ වචනයට
not bringing God's word into our understanding
දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ වචනය අපේ තේරුම් ගැනීමේ ලෝකයට ගෙනෙන්නේ නැතුව
and today that's what many people are doing
ඒ දේ තමයි ගොඩක් අද කරන්නේ
many people believe that money is the answer to every problem in life
ගොඩක් අය විශ්වාස කරනවා හැම ප්‍රශ්නයකටම පිළිතුර මුදල් කියලා
so they go to the gospel and try to find places where you can believe and get money
එනිසා සවිශේෂී එවැනි ස්ථානවලට ගිහිල්ලා උන් විශ්වාස කරනවා මුදල් ලබා ගන්නට.
So therefore people who teach that get a lot of people.
එනිසා ඒ පිළිබඳ උගන්වන අයටත් ගොඩක් දේ ලැබෙනවා.
Because it fits in with how you believe the world is.
මන්ද ඔබ විශ්වාස කරන ලෝකය ඒ නිසා.
Others believe that you know God will never let you have a problem in life.
ඒ වගේම සමහර අය විශ්වාස කරනවා දෙවියන් වහන්සේ කවදාකවත් ප්‍රශ්න වන්නේ නැහැ කියලා
ජීවිතේට. He will never put you to shame.
කවදාකවත් ලැජ්ජාවට ඔබව පත් කරන්නේ නැහැ කියලා.
Because we believe that that's the best way to live.
මන්ද අපි විශ්වාස කරන එහෙම තමයි හොඳම විදිය ජීවත් වෙන්න කියලා.
So you pick out words from the Bible that will confirm that.
ඒ නිසා ඒ ස්ථිර කරන වචන අපි තෝරගන්නවා බයිබලෙන්.
But we have to only look at Jesus Christ to see that he made a big mistake.
නමුත් එතකොට අපි බලන්න අවශ්‍ය ජේසුගේ ජීවිතය දිහා. එහෙනම් ජේසුට ලොකු වැරදීමක් සිදු වුණා.
Because he put to shame.
මන්ද උන්වහන්සේ ලැජ්ජාවට පත් කළා.
He was rejected.
උන්වහන්සේ ප්‍රතික්ෂේප කළා.
He was powerless.
උන්වහන්සේ බල රහිත වුණා.
So thank God we can selectively read the Bible also.
එනිසා අපි ස්තුති කරන්න ඕනේ අපිට අවශ්‍ය විදිහට දේ වචනේ කියවන්නට පුළුවන් කම.
So we can skip those things we don't like.
ඉතින් අපි අකමැති දේ අපිට මග හරින්නට පුළුවන්.
And we can only pick up the ones we like.
අපි කැමති දේ පමණක් අපිට තෝරා ගන්නට පුළුවන්.
We can tell each other beautiful things that we like to hear.
අපි එකිනෙකට කියන්නට පුළුවන් අපි අහන්නට කැමති දේ.
And continue to live in our foolish world.
ඒ තුල අපි මෝඩ ලෝකයක ජීවත් වෙන්නට පුළුවන්.
Yes, upon years upon years.
අවුරුදු ගණනාවක් එසේ ජීවත් වෙන්නට පුළුවන්.
Or we can allow God's word to give us a breakthrough.
එහෙම නැත්නම් අපිට ඉඩ දෙන්නට පුළුවන් දෙවියන් වහන්සේට අපගේ ජීවිතයට බලපෑමක් කරන්නට.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So Isaiah 55 verse 10.
Yesaya 55 10.
As the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return to it without watering the earth and making it bud and flourish so that it yields seed
for the sower
and bread for the eater
ආසෙන් වැටෙන හිමහා වසින වැස්ස නැවත හැරී නොගොස් පොළව සරුසාර කර පැල නංවා
කරල් හටගන්වා
වපුරන්නාට ධාන්‍යද
මිනිසාට ආහාරද ගෙන දෙයි So Harry has managed to get into that toss. But here he's become Hari. Verse 11. So is my word. That goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty. But will accomplish. What I desire. And achieve the purpose. For which I sent it.
එලෙස මා මුවින් නික්මෙන
වචන මා වෙතම
හිස්ව නොපැමින මාගේ අදහස්
සඵල කර
නියමයන් සිකුරටම ඉටු කරයි
Praise the Lord. It's a revelation about God's word.
ඉන්සා දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ වචනේ පිළිබඳව අනාවරණයක් මෙතන.
The word of God will always accomplish what it has set out to do.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ වචනේ හැම විටම ඒ කරන්නට යන දේ සම්පූර්ණ කරනවා.
Because it has hidden power.
මන්ද ඒ තුල සැඟවුණු බලයක් තියෙනවා.
Now, how do you explain that?
කොහොමද අපි ඒක තේරුම් කරන්නේ?
You know that there is something in the world called nuclear power.
Obadan
paramanu balavega.
Obadanwa loke balayak thiyena paramanu balavege kiyala.
Now nobody could use nuclear power till maybe 75 years ago.
Meeta avurudu 75kata kalin kaatwat me paramanu balaya pawichchi kirimata beriwa thibuna.
Because they didn't know how to split the atom.
මන්ද උන් දැනගෙන හිටියේ නෑ පරමාණුවක් කොහොමද දෙබෑ කරන්න කියලා.
Because I'm going to put her in trouble by explaining, you know, the atom has, I'll explain that. The atom has two parts. One is called the nucleus. The other is called the electron. So the nucleus of one atom will never meet a nucleus of another atom. Because if both of them meet, it's bad news. Because when the two nucleus meet, there is a repulsion and a release of energy. That release of energy is called atomic fusion, an explosion. So what they found was, they found a method to bring two atoms together.
and create such a pressure through creating more and more atoms that finally two nucleus of two atoms met. Then you release energy, such a level of energy that it destroyed Hiroshima and Nagasaki in one single moment. Now when they found the method to release the power from the atom, now for the first time human beings had something called nuclear power, because he found the method to release the what is hidden inside the atom. I think paramanua paramanuye nyastiyak thiyenawa, electronayak thiyenawa. Nastiyai hamu unoth echchara honda subaranchiyak nemei. Eke e hamuvima athule athi wena aavegeeta balayeta pipirimak athi wenawa. Ithin nasti deka happala pipirimak athi karanne manusyo igena gatta. Eket hetuwa paramanuwa weda ganna widiya anduna gatta avurudu das ganakata passe. In the same way, you can translate that.
E aakaryatama
the Bible is telling us,
devachane apita kiyala denawa,
God's word has power,
deviyan wahansege wachane balayak thiyena bawa,
but you must learn how to release that power.
Namuth e balaye pitara galannata api igena gannata ona.
And if you learn the method, the principle that God has put into place,
deviyan wahanse deela thiyena e aakarya api therum gattot,
God's power will be released into our lives.
Deviyan wahansege balaya ape jeevitha kara gaman karana.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. So now most people know what that power is. It's called faith.
Enisa me balaya viswasaya kiyala api dannawa.
Now to cause a nuclear fusion, you have to heat the atoms. So like that you have to have faith.
Paramanu ekata ekathu karanda
rat karanno ona paramanu rat karanno ona wage you need faith to release
e wage deviyan wahansege balaya api tulin eliyata ennata viswasaya awashyai.
But the problem is our prison.
Namuth prashne tamai api hirageek inne.
When we release faith,
enisa viswasaya athi wenakota,
we most of the time believe according to our own understanding.
Api boho welawata api viswas karanne apita terena vidiyata,
and therefore we never get the benefit of God's word.
Enisa devan wahansege wacchane sampurnayenma apita prayojaneeta gannata berinawa.
Why is that? Because we are interpreting the word according to our own prison.
Manda api hira gedara kiyindala e anuway api therum karanne.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Are you following what I'm saying? So we are limiting God's blessing to material prosperity.
එනිසා අපි දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ වචනය ලෞකික අවශ්‍යතාවයන් වලට සීමා කරනවා.
දේව ආශිර්වාදේ. We are limiting God's goodness to not having problems.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ යහපත අපි ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැතුව ජීවත් වෙන්නට සීමා කරනවා.
We can't see beyond that.
අපිට ඉන්නේ එහාට පේන්නේ නැහැ.
And that's why today's gospel.
එනිසායි අද දේව වචනේ.
Because in the gospel,
සුවිශේෂය කියනවා.
Jesus is telling us, come out of your prison and see life as I see it.
Yesu kiyenwa obage hiragein eliyata ewilla mama dakina widiyata aalokeyen dakinnata
kiyala. That's the liberating power of the gospel.
Eka thamai suvisheshaye thiyena nidahas wime balaya.
It's freeing us from our little world.
Ape kuda lokeyen apiwa nidahas karanawa.
And taking us into the world of Jesus Christ.
Apita Yesuge lokeyata apiwa geniyenawa.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. It's very exciting when you think about it.
Eka harima thrasya janakai oba e hitana kota.
Because we are coming into the heart and mindset of the word of God itself, Jesus Christ.
Manda api Yesu deela thiyena de wacchane hadawatatama gaman karanawa.
And we are coming out of our prison.
Api hiragein eliyata enawa.
So today when you read the gospel now,
enisa den suvisheshe kiyawanakata,
put this light on.
Me aalokaya oba daaganna.
Here is the hidden heart of Jesus.
Menna Yesuge sangawunu hadawata.
This is how he thought.
Menna mehemai unwahanse situwe.
This is how he saw.
උන්වහන්සේ දැක්කේ මෙහෙමයි.
And he's inviting us to see life in that same way.
අපිටත් උන්වහන්සේ ආරාධනා කරනවා ඒ ආලෝකයම බලන්නට කියලා.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So don't try to be smart. Don't try to think no, I have a better thing view than Jesus Christ.
එනිසා හිතන්නේ නැහැ මට තියෙනවා ජේසුට තියෙනවට වඩා හොඳ අදහසක්
කියලා. Leave aside your prison and enter his world.
අපගේ හිරගෙවල් පසක තියලා ජේසුගේ ලෝකෙට අපි අද ඇතුල් වෙමු.
Matthew 6 verse 7.
Matthew 6 7.
Matthew 6 7. Actually, we don't have to read this in Sinhala because it's projected here. So what we can do is we'll read only in English. Save us another 5-6 minutes. So those who are following in Sinhala can read the text here. Api Sinhalin kiyawanne hethuwa Bible e kotasa api danawa Sinhalin. E nisa eka bala ganna puluwa. Api English in kiyawanne. And when you pray, do not keep on babbling like pagans.
Do not keep on babbling like pagans.
Must have been about new song methods, hip hop babbling. Okay. For they think
they will be heard
because of their many words. Verse 8. Do not be like them. For your father knows
what you need
before you ask him. Verse 9. This then is how you should pray. Can you see the light now? Torch is coming. He's saying, don't live in your prison. Here, I'll teach you the way to see things. You should pray. Our Father in heaven. Hallowed be your name. Modern interpretation would be hello. You know, telephone. Take the telephone. You are hailing hello. So you say hello to God and say, you are okay. I'm talking to you. Hello, how are you? Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Okay. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. 13. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. 14. For if you forgive men when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Verse 15. But if you do not forgive men their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins. So, let's start. You read the scripture, this from 7 to 15, 8 verses. Underline what jumps at you. And when you underline what jumps at you, ask the question, why is it that this text jumped at me? And then you can answer. So try the method of Jesus talking directly to you. My son, my daughter, I'm speaking this from this text to you. So you can try that method.
දැන් මේ වචන 7 ඉඳලා 15ට කියවලා තමන්ගේ හදවතට බලපාන වචන යටින් ඉරක් ඇඳගෙන ප්‍රශ්නයක් අහන්න ඇයි මගේ හදවතට මේ වචන බලපාන්නේ කියලා. ඊට පස්සේ එයින් ලැබෙන පණිවිඩය ජේසු කෙලින්ම ඔබට කතා කරන භාෂාවෙන් ලියන්න. මගේ දුවේ මගේ පුතේ කියලා ඒ වගේ කෙලින්ම ඒ ලැබෙන වචනය ලියන්න ගන්න.
Okay. Now, like yesterday, speak with the one next to you. Now, what do you do? Each one will tell the other what they have heard from the Lord. Don't interpret that and say, no, no, that's not what it means. This is not, but each one listens to what the other one has heard. So we are hearing God's voice twice. One from come into our prison and coming out, going into another's prison and coming out. Occasionally the Holy Spirit can give us a breakthrough and break out of that prison. Okay. So let's start. Now, like yesterday, if you think that your partner has a good insight, you know, your partner has a good insight, can you lift your hand just up? No one has a good insight. No one. Anyone? You think you are listening to your partner and you thought, my God, that's a good insight for everyone to hear. Can you lift your hand? Yes, come. You tell the verse first and then we...
The verse is verse 14.
Verse 14. Can you put verse 14? Okay.
If you forgive others their failings, your Heavenly Father will forgive yours.
Okay.
This verse was shared both by me and my partner. It was the same verse that we got. It says, my daughter, you forgive others, but it's mostly in your heart, but your inability to show it and admit it is not pleasing to me. There is a barrier there. That is the place where we both had the same feeling that we cannot face up to that situation. The admitting it and going back to the person and trying, because of reasons that we are showing it, feeling within that, the other person is not in the way, it's only you in the way, do they understand this? And you keep on wondering and worrying whether you can face up to this situation. And that there comes a question in your heart whether really, how do we face that situation? Yes, you forgive in your heart, but you are not forgiving externally. So, as such, we are withdrawing and we are just surrendering it to the Lord only and carrying on a daily life with more or less, no communication, no keeping it within your heart and suffering.
Praise the Lord. Excellent. Now, if you look at what she said, you can translate. Do you think God actually spoke to her or not? What do you think? Yes, the Lord spoke to her. Yes. She received the insight. Now, that is something that you don't see in the text itself. But through the word, she was led to find something that was hidden in her own life. Till you do that, you are interpreting scripture. You know, you are explaining what the scripture means. So I'm interpreting, you are interpreting, we can nicely interpret and remain the same. And we can become professors of interpretation but remain the same. But then God spoke to her. My daughter, you are forgiving but you are not showing your forgiveness. But if you pray a little more, the Lord will begin to show you that. It is fear that prevents us from really showing it. They will climb on our head. They will take advantage. Somebody said those days people used to say hell to pay. you have to pay a heavy price. But then we have this beautiful answer. We accept that we need to do that. And then we ask the Holy Spirit, give me the grace and the strength to do that. That becomes your prayer after receiving a revelation.
Irvasse api karannata one shuddhaatmayan wahansege yaaknya karana apita anugrahaya dennata kiyala e labunu wachaneya kriyawata yomu karanna.
Give me the grace to show this in practice.
ස්වාමිනී මට අනුග්‍රහය දෙන්න මේ අධ්‍යක්ීමෙන් ක්‍රියා කරන්නට කියලා.
Then you wait for a leading.
එතකොට ඔබ බලාගෙන ඉන්නවා උන්වහන්සේගේ මඟ පෙන්වීමක් ලැබෙනකල්.
Give me a leading today that there will be a breakthrough in this thing.
අද මට මඟ පෙන්වීමක් දෙන්න ස්වාමිනී මෙන් එහාට යන්නට කියලා.
So therefore then it's not done only by our own strength.
එතකොට අපේ බලයෙන් අපේ උත්සාහයෙන් නෙමෙයි දේ කරන්නේ.
Because God's word will always show that we are limited.
මන්ද දේ වචනේ හැම වෙලෙම අපිට පෙන්නනවා අපි සීමා සහිතයි
කියලා. But that doesn't mean that we can't go beyond this limit.
එන් කියන්නේ අපිට එන් එහාට යන්නට බැහැ කියලා.
Because there's power in the word.
මන්ද දේ වචනේ බලයක් තියෙනවා.
So when you this that's why he said it will never come back to me empty.
ඒ නිසා දේ වචනේ කිව්වේ නැවත එය හිස් වෙන්නේ නැහැ කියලා
දේ වචනේ. So you hold that in your heart.
එයා අපි හදවතේ දරා ගන්නවා.
You surrender to the truth.
ඒ සත්‍යයට අපි අවනත වෙනවා.
And you open to the leading.
අපි ඒ අනුගමනය කරන්න අපි විවෘතව සිටිනවා.
What you thought you couldn't do, God will make it happen.
මට කරන්නට බැහැ කියලා හැඟුණු දේ උන්වහන්සේ මන් තුලින් එතකොට කරගන්නවා.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Excellent. I think we need to learn, you know, learn from these things. You know, this is how you grow deeper into the inner revelations. And practicing it is the only way. Enda.
මේ දවස්වල මම මගේ ගෙදර මගේ දරුවන් මගේ සහෝදරයන් එක්ක දකින ඒ ප්‍රශ්න හැම එකකටම මුළුමනින්ම සමාව දෙන්න කියලා වල්ල මගේ හදවතට කතා කරා.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Anyone else? Yes, come brother. Beautiful.
The person who shared with me had referred to the passage that talks about babbling and she had said that often we get carried away when we sit to prayer with beautifully explaining our struggle to God as opposed to sitting understanding that God sees my struggle and listening.
Praise the Lord. Yeah, excellent. Like babbling on the phone. Anyone else who likes to share? I'm sure there must be people who are willing to share. Yeah? Come. Beautiful. Today is the Young Men's Day. Excellent. When you see young people coming forward.
Good morning, everyone.
Yeah.
I'm not kind of used to this. I'm having a bit of a cold feet. Well, I very seldom read the scriptures, to be honest. And what really hit me was God knows what you need before you ask Him. So that, it just struck me like that. Just, I'm lost for words, to be honest. Well, it really, because a blessing would be like when you go through a struggle, it really a blessing for you. So that what I realized, so when you go through a struggle, that is a blessing that God gives you. So as the idiom says, like, you know, I was given lemons and I made lemonade out of it. So all praise and thanks to God. And this has made me mature and has given me the faith. I mean, I have grown in faith and it's amazing. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. So the beautiful thing is he was not a Christian, you know, and he has found the Lord and he's walked into the inner journey. And it's a gift as a whole family. Yes. So time up. So for me, the word that really, you know, this beautiful, I've reflected, I've preached this. It's so rich. But today what hit me was, you know, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Hello, Father. You know, I acknowledge, you know, there's a loving Father above. He's super rich. He's in charge. Everything is under control. And I need to enjoy today. He is in complete charge of the whole situation. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes, let's give the Lord a mighty hand. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. 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 Actually, what she shared is a good method to follow. What is the method? My daughter, and he shared what the Lord told him. Try that tomorrow. You always have tomorrow, day after. Next week we do another method. You know, it's another kind of method we are going to use. But this week, let's learn this method so that you can use it whenever you pray, at when you sit before the Lord to pray. Shall we stand and be in His presence? Let's build a throne of praise and worship to the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Glory to your name. Praise you, Father. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Glory to you, Father. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise you, Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Bless you, Lord. Glory to your name. Worship your Father. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Glory to your name. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory.
them daily, let incense arise. Day and night, night and day, let incense arise. Day and night, night and day, let incense arise. Day and night, night and day, let incense arise.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Bless us.